Dr. Mitchell Wainwright, a board-certified family medicine physician. And Dr. Wainwright is calling from, where are you calling from, doctor?
It's called San Juan Capistrano, about an hour south of Los Angeles, an hour north of San Diego.
Tell the other black person there, Doug Starks, we said hi.
You know what? You're about right, but I was born in Oakland, so hey, I know our people.
Okay.
I'm in LA, so I'm up with you, man.
Yeah.
All right. There we
All
go.
All right. Yeah. Welcome to 4:30 in the morning.
Thank you.
I mean 3:30. I'm sorry. 3:30. Okay. Hey, Doc, the subject is obesity and hypertension in African-American women. Already I'm getting texts from women saying, well, what about fat men, too? No, we're not talking about us. We're talking about African-American women. Obesity and hypertension disproportionately African-American women than any other race?
You know, you're right. At about 60% of all African-American women are obese, compared to 32% of all white women. And just walk around our community and just look at people and just decide, hey, are they obese or are they normal weight? And when I walk around, I'm a little disappointed in ourselves that we don't recognize this. I was actually listening to a pretty prominent African-American actress, and somebody asked her about obesity, and she says, I'm not obese, I'm juicy. And you know, when somebody has that platform and they don't admit to being obese, what does that do to our young African-American women who are or children who listen to that person? You have to own what you are.
How about owning that?
Big boned it. There's no such thing as big boned it, right?
That's an excuse. But I have to admit this. What African-American women and Latino women have higher bone densities than white women or Asian women, but big bone doesn't get it. What happens to us, we become obese, and that leads to other health issues.
Mm-hmm. Is it in our DNA?
No. I'm going to say this. I mean, I don't believe it's in our DNA. Obesity is not in anybody's DNA. Obesity is in people's kitchens and their lack of exercise.
And so, right. Doctor, what about how do we stop it? Because it seems like as we get to that middle-aged part of our lives, and then all of a sudden, for many of us, I know it doesn't seem realistic, but it's like we wake up and all these pounds have hit us.
and you can't get them off.
And very difficult.
All right, you bring up a very interesting question. People ask me, hey, is my menopause causing my weight gain? The answer is no. What happens here is that as we age, we maintain the same caloric intake, the same amount of food, but we're less active. And so all of a sudden, you have less activity and you're gaining weight. So an inactive female should eat about 1,600 calories a day.
How much?
An inactive male, 1,600. An inactive male should eat about 1,800 calories a day. An active male, 1,900. Inactive male, 1,900. And an active male, 2,200. So all of a sudden, we're saying I'm less active, but I'm eating the same foods. And yes, I'm eating foods that are maybe not good for me. So I'm eating carbohydrates and sugars, whereas you should be eating lean proteins and salads and green vegetables. But then that's very difficult. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
No. But so it's just a matter of changing when we're going through the change.
Well, you know, okay, let's be real about this. In African-American communities, you have food deserts. A lot of the major supermarkets have left our communities. So all of a sudden, you have people who, well, where do I get my fruits and vegetables? Is it at the local liquor store? And how fresh are those fruits and vegetables? And all of a sudden, you in our communities, the African-American male is not doing what he needs to do. He needs to be at home with his families instead of they're incarcerated, they're not working. And all of a sudden you have women who are out here now, out there in the workforce. And so when they get home, they have kids to feed. Are they going to sit down and cook that healthy meal? Or all of a sudden they're saying, I can go get a dollar meal, get five meals for $5. Or can I go out and get something get something cheaper and feed these kids, because these kids want to eat. The kids don't care what they eat. They want to eat, but they're eating foods that are not good for them. So this is a socioeconomic issue. But I'm going to say one thing. They did a study that said that white women and Asian women in high socioeconomic classes had less obesity rates than African-American women in the same socioeconomic class, because we do not eat right.
So
my
Dr.
family's from... Go ahead, please.
I'm sorry. Just wanted to because a lot of this has to do with us not wanting to take more medication or medication at all. So how can we do this, lower our cholesterol, lower our blood pressure, and lose weight by eating properly? What's the DASH eating system?
Okay, so listen, the DASH eating plan was developed by the National Institutes of Health to lower blood pressure without medication, which is a unique idea. But understand that high blood pressure, we African Americans have higher blood pressures than any other race on this planet. But what the DASH says is that it's a lifelong dietary approach to healthy eating to prevent or treat hypertension. And the diet focuses on decreasing sodium intake and eating foods that contain potassium, calcium, and magnesium, which helps you lower your blood pressure. And there's two types of DASH diets. There's a standard DASH, which says that you can consume 2,300 milligrams of sodium per day. And the lower DASH limits you to 1,500 milligrams of sodium per day. But listen to this. The typical American diet contains 3,400 milligrams of sodium per day. So to get down to these numbers, you have to really decrease your sodium intake.
Now, we could go on and on, and you're going to be around the next hour to talk to texters at 646464, and your article on blackamericaweb.com is very extensive and very detailed. I recommend everyone, especially African-American women and men, listen, check it out. Hey, Dr. Wentworth, Wainwright,
Dr. Mitchell Wainwright.
Dr. Mitchell Wainwright, thank you so much for helping us on Get Well
Wednesday.
I really
appreciate it.
All right.
I hope people listen, all right?